My name is Dr. Marwa Casey. I'm a board-certified neurologist and a multiple sclerosis specialist, and I practice at Cedars-Sinai. And one of the things I am very passionate about in my practice is the diagnosis and misdiagnosis of MS. This is not something I was particularly interested in during training, but once I really started seeing patients, and I have seen thousands of people with MS, it became obvious that people who had been told they have MS don't actually have it. Quite a few of them. And I heard story after story of people being misdiagnosed, being told they have it, some of them starting on medication, some of them getting tattoos of things like the National MS Society ribbon, things like that. And you look at the diagnostic criteria, you look at their case, and you realize that they have something else. And this is, you know, as devastating as it is to hear you have MS, it is maybe more devastating to hear that you don't have it, because that means that you have something else and you've been treated for the wrong thing for maybe years, right? So I saw enough of these patients, and really after just the first one, became very, very interested in trying to do something about it. So part of my research is in developing new diagnostic tools. The other part is in defining the problem and bringing attention to it and making neurologists aware that we are not doing a perfect job and that they need to have their antennae up and be thinking about this when they see somebody with MS. So every single person I see with MS, every new patient that walks into my office, no matter how long they've had the diagnosis, no matter who diagnosed them and how wonderfully trained that specialist is, or if it's a general neurologist I've never heard of, doesn't matter. The very first thing I do is do my best to confirm that they actually have MS. How do I do that? I talk to them about their symptoms, because that's the first part of the diagnostic criteria. I look at their MRIs, I do an exam if necessary, I look at other studies they've had done, I think about other conditions that they could have that they haven't been tested for. And we go into a lot more detail about the diagnostic criteria of MS and how we diagnose MS in my course, Conquer MS. So find that if you're interested in more information about that. That's one little subsection of it, but we go into a lot more detail. But anyway, the first thing I do is I take a step back and I say, well, I don't care how long they've had MS, do they actually have it? Can I prove that they have it? Do they meet the diagnostic criteria? And 4 out of 5 times the answer is yes, but up to 1 in 5 times, up to 20% of people who have been told they have MS don't have it. This is a big study that I did a couple of years ago, looking at people coming new into the Cedars Clinic or that UCLA clinic where I also worked in the past. And these were new referrals for things that didn't have anything to do with the diagnosis. They were coming to us to talk about disease-modifying therapy, or because their neurologist had retired and they needed someone else, they just moved to the area. But again, because we start every visit with confirming the diagnosis, we were able to go back and look at how many times we had to undo the diagnosis of MS in people, and it was up to 1 in 5 in both clinics. Totally independent clinics, but similar numbers in both, which tells us that maybe other MS centers are seeing the same thing. And yeah, when I talk to my colleagues, other MS specialists, they say, yes, we see this all the time too. We're glad you put a number on it. That sounds about right to us. And a study that we just very recently published, this was led by Dr. Andrew Solomon, who's the head of the MS Center at the University of Vermont, and one of my mentors and someone who really supported my interest in this topic and brought me onto his research. And what he led us through was a survey. We surveyed 222 neurologists, and these are people who are not MS specialty trained, but they are neurologists out there in the field who are routinely diagnosing MS as part of their practice. And we gave them a survey to see how well they understood the current MS diagnostic criteria, how well they can apply them, and they did not do very well, unfortunately. So we had them, part of the diagnosis of MS, and again, we get into more detail on this in Conquer MS with some examples if you're interested, but part of it is identifying white spots or lesions or plaques on an MRI that are actually specific to MS and caused by MS, because 100 things can cause white spots on an MRI, and you have to know which ones actually look like they're MS lesions. And out of these 222 people, 2% got it right. 2%. These are people who are routinely diagnosing MS in their practice. When we asked them about specific criteria for the multiple part of MS, how well do you know how to satisfy that criteria? About 61% correctly identified one of them, which is dissemination in time. Fewer identified dissemination in space. So we did the survey just to highlight that Not that people are bad or they're stupid. Obviously, these are well-respected colleagues of ours who are out there doing their best. But it is more that, one, there needs to be more education around these diagnostic criteria and more continuing education, because they're revised every few years in a way that makes them better, but we need to actually use them. But two, and I think this is more my focus and my passion, is can we introduce new tests into these criteria that make it a little more foolproof, right? Part of these criteria is honestly a little bit subjective. Not really, it's not supposed to be, but the way people use it is subjective. They're a little bit loosey-goosey with them. They can't actually identify what the criteria are when they're given a test, right? 2% of them got it right. So can we cut out that whole messy process, and can we give them a very specific MRI that says, yes, this person has MS, or no, they don't, from the beginning? Just prints it out in the report as soon as someone gets their MRI. Can we even develop a blood test for MS, right? Can we have someone just go to the lab and give them a test that says, yeah, this person probably has MS, or no, they really probably don't, and you should be looking for something else. So this new study, it was just published in Multiple Sclerosis Journal recently. The lead author is Dr. Andrew Solomon. And go read it, go take a look at what we did. Especially if you are a neurologist, go take a look at what we're getting wrong. And I don't mean to imply that MS specialists get it right 100% of the time. We don't either. And again, that's part of, you know, as well as we understand the diagnostic criteria, even we don't get it right every single time. And that is because it's not always simple. It's not always straightforward. People do not come in as like a cookie cutter mold of they fit into this or they don't fit into that. Everybody and every brain is different. And so we desperately need new tools that can help us be more accurate about the diagnosis and to get it right earlier. And this survey is just part of our kind of growing momentum, pushing us towards something like that.